video, I'm going to introduce here one more ChatGPT alternative tool, that is Copy.ai. For reaching this Copy.ai, we had to go to the Google interface. There we had to type Copy.ai. Then after that, press enter. When you give this enter, we may get here the search report from the Google. So under this, the first one, www.copy.ai. These are tools might help for us to write a better marketing copy or content with AI. So this is the way they given me explanation of this tool. Then we have to click it here. Once we click it, it goes to the home page of the copy.ai. This is the interface of the copy.ai. So the first time user, we have to go for yes, sign up with Google or sign up with email. So just I'm going to scroll down the things which is available in the case of description about the tool. It's available. If you need, just you can explore it. Yes. So here I'm already having the account. That is the reason I'm just going to the login. So I'm clicking the login and logging through my Gmail account. I'm logging here. So once I click the login, it goes to the user interface. This is the user interface of the individuals. For example, you can see this is my Thiyagu workspace. It seems that it is my workspace. Yeah. Here you can see the uniqueness of the tool look like a ChatGPT or in the case of bot. So when you go for a user interface showing this welcome to chat by copy.ai, and it gives some kind of description about the tool, real-time search and long form content as well as the brainstorm ideas. Like this, they given some kind of descriptions in this. And the left side, you can find chat options. In the tools, we have some options. These are the tools available, favorite tool, recent tools, growth ideas, crazy YouTube ideas. Even we can get a crazy YouTube ideas. Guest to copywriting, rewrite keywords, sentence rewriter. Like this, they given a lot of options in this. So just you can explore it. Then similarly, there is a favorite tool, recent tool. Like this, they given you some kind of separate features also. And if you click the template, we can see the templates. There is a different templates like blog post wizard, write blog intro, then write blog outline. Like this, they given a lot of templates option. Even we can click this separate feature from here. Then if you like to go with the project, you can see the project. There is a workflow option and workflow library. And this way it's showing this interfaces. If you like to go for a prompting, look like ChatGPT or in the bot, when you go for a prompting, we can use this prompting option. See, ask or search anything here. Here I like to ask the questions. How can we use the micro learning strategy in higher education? So this is a question I want to ask the prompting in the case of copy.ai. Then after this, we have to press the enter button, or there is an option called the enter, like the arrow mark. So here we have to press it. So once I click it here, I can find the responses. Now the copy.ai is giving you responses. See the wonderful response, like micro learning strategies is giving wonderful responses. Big size models, mobile learning, just in time, like this give you wonderful responses. Under this, if you like to copy, you can copy this and we can paste it in the Word document. And there is an option called add to editor. Suppose you like to directly do some kind of editing, we can do it from here. And we can get a summary report, 305 words, 2359 character. These are the things, it's compared to all other tools, it's a new things I found it from here. And we can do here some kind of customization like bold, italic, underline. These are the customizations available. So this way, this tool is to be unique compared to all these tools. And other things, there is option called attach. Even we can ask the prompting after attach the file. For example, if you click this attach, we have it's automatically showing to upload your file from your desktop or any other file location you want to click. You can click and we can go for a upload. So once you click upload, based on the upload, we have to ask a prompting. So that is a one more good features available in this case. And suppose if you like to go with the browse prompt, for example, sometimes we cannot know what way we have to raise the questions or what way we have to ask the question. For this, they given you this option also. Normally, there is a some kind of third-party tools might helping to find a prompting. But here, the tool itself, there's a prompting. If I click this prompts, we may get a different forms like content, SEO, then email marketing, paid ads, recruitment, recruiting, sales, social media, like this. They're given some kind of prompting idea for us. Even you can use this idea, the same idea based questions or prompting we can ask in the chatbot. So this way, this tool is somewhat unique because most other tools like Perplexity or in the ChatGPT or in the case of board. Also, this kind of browse prompt is not available, but this tool having a good browse prompting is that. So this way, I like very much to use this. And this is a like and dislike symbol. If you like to give you a like and dislike, we can do this. And this is here some of the option like copy link. Suppose you like to copy the link and you want to share the people, you can do this. And if you want to rename this name of this particular title, then we can change it. If you want to delete, we can delete it. And there is other options called clear chat. Suppose you want to delete the entire chat, you can click this clear chat. The automatically then the chat may be removed from this interface. So this way the tool is to be unique and it's very user friendly compared to all other tools. Hope these videos might be useful for you. Thank you so much to join to see my video. We will see in this next video. Bye.